Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric, and I make apps. Now today, let's answer the question, can anyone become an app developer? So the other day I got an email from someone, I think they were just finishing high school or in high school age, and they were asking whether or not anyone can become an app developer. It was just like, hey Eric, can anyone become an app developer, or you know, do you have to go qualifications or anything? And of course I had to give the bad news. I hate it when it falls on me to give the bad news, and you other app developers out there will know this, that becoming an app developer is actually really difficult and there's a lot of tight requirements on it. First of all, you have to have an IQ of about 130 or above. You have to have gone to a prestigious university. You have to submit a proposal to the App Developer Tribunal, and they have to go away and you have to write up like a 5,000 word essay about why you deserve to be an app developer. And then the process could take anywhere between six months or 3 years. And then if they approve it, then you become an app developer trainee, and then you work your way up the ranks. All right, so I tried to think of like a really good story for that. Of course, all of that's fake. Yeah, anyone could become an app developer. I have to believe that, right? But having that kind of attitude is not all that uncommon, right? I once worked at a place, it was a small company, and I worked there as a consultant. This was a few years ago. This was for a web developer, ASP.NET kind of stuff. Right, so I go to this company, and the owner had called me, and they already had developers, so I went in there, and one of their main developers, he really didn't like me. Well, I mean, that's like normal. Like, if you go into someplace as a consultant or a contractor, you know, a lot of the existing employees will look at you as an intruder, and they, you know, you're not necessary anyway, so you're trying to, like, add value, but some of the first people you have to try to win over is the existing developers. So anyway, he had this theory that he could take anybody as long as their IQ was high enough and teach them to be a software developer. So he says, yeah, I could take like a doctor or a lawyer or something like that, and I could train them to be a software developer, but not people who are like, you know, mechanics or whatever. Although mechanics, I know we're very smart, right? And it was completely ridiculous. I couldn't believe he thought that way, right? And he was so condescending. He was condescending to everyone. He was condescending to the other people in the company. He was definitely condescending to me. Like, you know, everything you do, like if you make one little mistake, it's like, yeah, right? But he never made any mistakes. That kind of guy, right? So, and another place I worked, I had another guy who was a manager, and he was the kind of person who was really insecure about himself. So like, you could say anything to him and he would try to take that away from you, or he thought you were trying to take something away from him. Like, you could say, you know, I walked on the moon, and you'll say, I could have walked on the moon, right? He would always say he could have done something. So like, you'd say like, I went to go see a doctor, and he'll say like, you know, I could have been a doctor. I just didn't go to medical school. Like, he'll give like some like really obvious excuse why he didn't do it. Like, you know, and the thing about those two people, the one who thought you need to have an IQ and the second one who thought he could have been a doctor just as long as he went to medical school, the second guy was right, right? I think, you know, yeah, of course you could have been a doctor if you'd gone to medical school, right? One of the things about experience and becoming things like an app developer is you have to dedicate the time to get the experience, right? When I meet with clients, or people hire me either as a contractor or through Overpass or whatever, I never see it as they're hiring me because I'm super intelligent. They're hiring me because of my experience and my knowledge, right? And both of those things take time. So what they're buying is time, right? I have no doubt that anybody who's ever hired me in the past could go through and learn everything that I've learned and do everything that I've done, but it would take a long time, right? For those of you who have been a software developer for a while, you know, my experience has always been with each technology I learn and all the other developers I've worked with is you start off with Hello World, obviously. Then you go to spaghetti code and hey, it works, but it looks terrible. You have a few really bad errors, right? Hopefully, eventually, you'll get into a team and learn a little bit of structure and why things are done the way they're supposed to be. And then you'll get into the more advanced things, like, you know, you'll get the structure right, but then you get to more advanced things like design patterns, interfaces, encapsulations, unit tests, you know, decoupled services, all that kind of stuff. And that could take a long time to get there. So, but every time I meet with a client, I think, basically what they're buying from me is my time. The same way when I go to a mechanic, I think I could have fixed this car myself, except I don't know how and I don't know what anything does, right? But that's like a temporary problem. Right? And this is the way I've always thought. And you know, as opposed to the IT guy who was really condescending, I don't know if you've ever been to like to take the example of mechanic. You go to a mechanic, you go to someone who's really just like, he'll tell you how it is. He'll say, oh yeah, sure, we do this, we do this, and he'll explain everything to you. Even if you don't understand it, you're just like, okay, cool. You know, it just, or you go to the person who just really, you know, condescending, he thinks he's much smarter than you, and you're just like, whatever. Right? This is the same way when we deal with clients, is I always think, you know, they could have done this, but what I'm giving them is time. I'm doing it faster. The same is with companies that already have developers. They might, you know, like when we're calling around or whatever, I'll say, you know, we do app development. And it's, oh, we already got some developers, you know, web developers or whatever. And I'll say, you know, well, you know, that's really good because, but there's a learning curve with apps. So your web developers could do apps, but is a little bit of a learning curve. I have no doubt that they can do it, but it'll just take a bit of time, and then we can help shorten that distance of time, because time takes money, and it could be more expensive doing that than it does just hiring us, that kind of stuff. So anyway, I've always believed anyone could learn anything, but and I think the reason for this is because, you know, because I speak Chinese. So I've told this story before. When I was in high school, my grades were really, really bad. I did not do well in high school. In fact, when I got to the end of high school, when I graduated back in 1990, the choices for me were continue working in the McDonald's I worked in or join the military. And university was something I didn't even think I was smart enough to do. I had like real confidence issues there just because of the bad grades. When I actually did go to university, I did fine. I did really well, right? So. You know, I went to the Army recruitment office and they said, you know, you're really good at learning languages. And I thought, you know, I'm not. I failed French. Right? And then they said, you know, they said, no, this test shows that you're good at languages. We'd like to send you to language school. And I said, can I learn Russian? And they said, yeah, sure, that should be fine. We can't guarantee it. But yeah, I'm sure you'll get Russian. Right. And then when I got through basic training, went into the Army, towards the end of basic training, everyone got their language assignments. At least those are in the same job that I was, which is linguist, and they told me I was learning Chinese, right? And that was the kind of thing where I thought, I am not smart enough to learn Chinese. I cannot learn Chinese. But of course, you know, everything's possible with, you know, time and money, time and experience, right? So it was going through and learning all the tones and then the different vocabulary, stringing sentences together, learning the grammar, and then you know, a few years later, I'm sitting in Shanghai with a head of a software company discussing how Overpass can help them, right? But it's all just the time and stuff like that. So anyway, really rambling on this one. The short answer is yes, anyone can learn to be an app developer. If it's something you want to do, just don't let it deter you. I don't think there's, you know, you have to think about software languages. It's not like binary. The people who write the languages want it to be easy enough so that most people, first of all, it's not so easy that it's inflexible, but also that it's not impossible for people to understand. So anyway, that's it for today. I hope that's been useful. Let me know what you guys think. Do you disagree with me? Do you think you have to be super smart to be a software developer? Or do you think you just have the time to stumble about, learn everything, read everything you can, work with other people, and just really get good at it through experience, making mistakes, and just progressing? So anyway, that's it for today. That's it for this week. I will talk to you guys on Monday.